With the rise of video game graphics, realism, and the indie market, certain developers have decided to go all in with trying to gross the player out. You and me, and plenty of them, have definitely succeeded. What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, and welcome to Chaos Top 10s. Today, tonight, whenever you're watching this, we're going to be counting down 10 of the grossest games ever made. These are those games that, for whatever reason, never fail to make you cringe when gross stuff starts coming in. Obviously, viewer discretion is advised from here on out because this video is going to get, it's going to get a little nasty, okay? Let's go. Be sure to enter the monthly $200 Amazon gift card here on the channel. It's really easy to enter. All you have to do is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications for a chance to win. Leave a comment why you want it with your Twitter handle, and I will pick the winner at the end of the month. Good luck. Kicking off the list today is Whack Your Series, okay? The Whack Your Series is a bunch of little black and white games that focus on you getting revenge on certain people in your life, such as your boss, your ex, your neighbor, the list goes on and on. If there's someone annoying in your life, chances are that there's a Whack Your game about them. So, what are these games? Well, you have to find certain items in the room that you can use to assault the person the game is about to be, and, well, that you're about to go after. It's pretty graphic, and you win by using all the possible items available to you. What makes the game so gross, you may ask? Well, mainly because you're using regular household items to bludgeon these people, and the animation is very unique, and it just makes everything a little more gut-wrenching than it normally would be. Now, there's a pretty big difference between just shooting someone like we do in other games and crushing someone's head in with a filing cabinet or strangling them with phone cables like you do in Whack Your Games. It's a little out there. At number 9, the name says it all. There's Poop in My Soup. This little indie game was released on Steam in March of 2016. It's all about going crazy with your poops. You control your character traveling to various locations around the globe so you can poop on people from a safe altitude. You can poop on their face, on their food, on their dogs, on their kids. I mean, if you really get good at it, you can unlock special poo abilities to increase your efficiency in the projectile poop department. Now that I've said poop enough, strap yourself in because it doesn't stop here, just like poop. Are you ready? This one's gonna make me sick just talking about it. Ingrown toenail surgery. Of all the different fields of work a doctor could go into, being an ingrown toenail surgeon is probably one of the grossest, or at least one that needs to the most getting used to. But in case you're someone who has always wanted to be that person that helps relieve people of their ingrown toenails, I present to you Ingrown Toenail Surgery. It's a flash game that helps you live your dream, and this game is exactly what it sounds like. A very detailed simulation game of taking care of ingrown toenails on various patients. You can find this little game online for free if you really want to try. I don't know. You guys let me know if you're able to make it very far in the actual game. At number 7, we have South Park The Stick of Truth, the US version. This South Park RPG was released in March of 2014 to critical acclaim for its gameplay, its humor, and its faithfulness to the show. However, because it was so set on being like the show, that meant it was going to be pretty gross. There are actually a few different versions of the Stick of Truth released through the world in order to work with different censorship laws, but the US version was the only one to be released completely uncensored, and it's pretty disgusting, in a good funny way, honestly. Throughout your playthrough of the Stick of Truth, you'll come face to face with plenty of gross images like anal probing, an interactive abortion section, gory violence, and so much more. In the international versions of the game, much of the gross content was cut out and replaced with still frames describing what would be happening if it weren't censored. And it's pretty funny in a unique way, but it also crosses the line on some things. At number 6, we have Outlast 2, and the first Outlast was a great survival horror game with a good balance between atmospheric tension and gross-out scares to keep you on your toes. The sequel followed suit with both of these aspects, but they really went all out with the gross-out parts of the game. You played as a journalist trying to find their wife in a strange part of Arizona, seemingly only inhabited by crazy people who want nothing more than to just rip you apart, and they do so, over and over and over again. Throughout the game, you'll see stuff like very detailed buckets full of poop, people getting their junk ripped off, being force-fed human blood, first-person crucifixion scene. I mean, it's crazy, and it has one of the weirdest endings in recent gaming history. Outlast 2 is a decent horror game, but definitely don't play it if you have a very weak stomach. Okay, at number 5, this game isn't gross like the other ones on the list. In fact, it's pretty tame, but not by the title. Drowning Simulator. There's just something about what you're seeing on the screen that will never fail to make you cringe. Drowning Simulator puts you in the middle of an ocean and simply has you try to prolong your inevitable death as much as you can before you finally drown in the middle of seemingly endless bodies of water. Now, I think it's safe to say that most of us are afraid of drowning. And Drowning Simulator manages to tap into that common fear in a very, very truly disturbing way that just kind of makes you sick to your stomach. Although, I have to admit, the production quality for an indie game like this is pretty impressive, but I'm just not sold on the game's premise, the topic. I think we could have done without this game. But then again, we could have done without any of these games on this list. At number four, we have The Darkness 2. This first-person shooter was released in 2012 as a sequel to the 2007 Darkness, which was based on a series of comics that started all the way back in 1996. You played as a very disturbed mobster with a demonic power at his fingertips as you set out to avenge the death of his girlfriend, Jenny. That's how all these go. The Darkness 2 quickly got the attention of the gaming world for its very, very graphic violence and the creative ways that you could actually dispatch your enemies. For example, you could send one of your demonic tentacles up the guy's butthole and rip his spine right out of his body. Or you could then hold them upside down by their legs and rip them in half like a wishbone. You guys know, like Thanksgiving, you get the wishbone and you pull it, see who gets the good part, all while they scream in pain and their guts paint the walls red. Now, The Darkness 2 is it's a super fun game. A lot of people like it, and it has a great story. It really does, but the kills definitely are not for the faint of heart. Speaking of games that aren't for the faint of heart, at number three, we have A Dump in the Dark, another poop game. This one's a poop-based horror game. I'm not kidding. This actually exists. This game first plopped onto Steam, you see what I did there, in early access in January of 2017, had you playing as a butt that fires poop at demonic enemies from hell. Now, you may ask, why are there demonic enemies from hell? Well, because they came out of the toilet. You can use five different methods of pooping to combat your enemies in this game, such as liquid diarrhea, rapid fire, or even the dreaded sniper shot. You have to make it through 25 levels using your poop as a weapon, and believe it or not, it's got a pretty good reception on Steam. As of the recording of this video, 77% of the reviews have actually been positive, so for all I know, this actually may be one of the best games of the year. This may be game of the year for 2018, A Dump in the Dark. Okay, we seem to have some kind of poop fetish with this list. I apologize, okay? But at number two, we have Toilet Tycoon. Released on March 1st of the year 2000, Toilet Tycoon is an economic simulation game where you have to manage a sanitation company in a very strange town, specifically the toilets. You have to analyze what people are doing on your toilets and what's going in them. You have to figure out new toilet technology and even go to the competitors' toilets and sabotage them to eliminate the competition. Much like A Dump in the Dark, though, if you go on Steam and look at the reviews, Toilet Tycoon has a surprising rating of 80% positive. I guess we shouldn't be so immediately judgmental of games about poop, but I don't know. Give it a try if you want to, at your own discretion. And finally, on this just horrible list today, Conker's Bad Fur Day. Finishing off the list is the legendary 3D platformer from Rare, released on the Nintendo 64 in 2001. Now, when developing their new title, the Rare team decided they wanted to make something with a lighthearted look, but was extremely offensive and gross. And what they came up with and cooked up was Conker's Bad Fur Day, one of the funniest and most disgusting games ever made. Throughout the story, you'll go through worlds made entirely of poop. You'll witness various cute animals meet their gory demise. You'll have to use cow diarrhea as a puzzle solver during one part. And you'll even have a boss fight with a giant, slinging pile of poop trying to drown you in feces. Conker's Bad Fur Day is one of the best 3D platformers ever made. It's definitely worth a playthrough if you've never tried it, but I need you to be aware that you're not exactly going to have any type of appetite after you play this game, because this thing is on a whole nother level. And there you have it, my friends. Those are what I deem 10 of the grossest games ever made. You guys, let me know. What do you think is the grossest game out there? Let me know in the comment section. What game actually physically turned your stomach when you played it? Now, I know there's a lot of horror-based games out there. I mean, Until Dawn was pretty gross at times. So I want to know from you guys, which one sticks out with you? Is it one of these on this series, or is it one that we should have put on the video? As always, guys, turn on your notifications. Drop a like if you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you tomorrow night for a new video. It'll be hopefully way cleaner.